Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. So students, if you remember, in the last video we have discussed about the chapter 2, that was the story The Seed. So let us have the short video of it so that you can remember the story.
China, there lived a wise emperor whose once dark brain had turned the color of new fallen snow. He was old and it was time for him to choose a successor. Although he had many sons and grandsons to choose from, the emperor felt that power and wealth had made his heirs lazy. He wanted to appoint someone outside the family. Loud drums called a gathering of young men to the temple at the top of the mountain. When they arrived, the emperor, seated on a magnificent throne, announced, "It is time to choose the next emperor." The shocked townsmen whispered among themselves, "Nothing like this has ever happened before." The emperor continued,
"Today, each of you will take a seed. In 1 year, you will bring your plant to the temple."
A golden bowl filled with seeds was set before the crowd. Each person took just one seed. A young man named Jun was last in line. He chose his seed carefully, holding it tightly in his fist. He ran home to tell his mother. She listened to the story and gave him a beautiful blue and white porcelain bowl. Jun placed pebbles and then soil in the bowl and tenderly planted his seed. Each day, Jun carefully watered the seed. He watched and waited, but nothing happened. Others talked about their plants that were pushing up through the soil. Weeks passed, and still Jun's seed did not sprout. "Something's wrong," Jun thought, but he did not give up and kept watering his seed. Other men in the village put their original plants into bigger containers. Jun, he must have done something wrong. He prayed in the temple for a miracle. 6 months went by, and still nothing grew in his blue and white bowl. "Could I have killed my seed with too much water?" he wondered. All around in the village, there were containers filled with wonderful looking plants. But Jun's seed hadn't yet sprouted. The 1 year mark arrived, and it was time to carry the plants up the mountain to the temple. "I'm not taking my empty bowl." It hadn't yet sprouted. The 1 year mark arrived, and it was time to carry the plants up the mountain to the temple. "I'm not taking my empty bowl to the temple," Jun said to his mother. "You must go," she encouraged. "You have done your best and must keep your promise." Although Jun felt sad and a little embarrassed, he carried his empty bowl up the steep stone steps that led to the temple. When he arrived at the top, there were so many plants that it was easy to hide his empty bowl among them.
"Those are the most beautiful plants I've ever seen," exclaimed the emperor as he sat on his throne.
As he stood up and walked around, he noticed the empty blue and white porcelain bowl behind a big plant.
"What's this?"
he questioned, holding the bowl in his hands. Jun tried to hide, but those near him laughed and pushed him forward.
"What is your name?"
the emperor asked. "My name is Jun," he whispered, without looking up.
"Why did you bring me an empty bowl?"
he questioned.
"My seed didn't grow," Jun replied. "I failed."
"You did not fail,"
the emperor said.
"Last year, I passed out seeds and told you all to plant them. But the seeds I gave you had been boiled. None of them could have possibly grown."
He raised his voice and spoke to the crowd.
"When you found out that your seeds would not sprout, you substituted other
is why Jun will be the next emperor.
So students, I hope you understand the video, you remember the video. So now let us see the exercise of this chapter, and I hope you have done the word meanings of this chapter as well as you have underlined all the difficult words. Okay, so now let us see the comprehension A1 part of this. This is choose the correct answer. First one is, why did the king want someone from outside the family to succeed him? Why king selected his successor from outside? So first option is that he had no sons. B, he liked outsiders more. And C, his heirs were lazy. So which is the correct option? The correct option is that his heirs were lazy. If you remember the story, it was written in that all the power and wealth made his sons and grandsons lazy. So therefore C is the correct answer. Then second one is, Chun Si did not sprout, yet he took his empty bowl to the temple. Why? Chun Si didn't sprout, but he took. Why? A option is, he was afraid that he would be punished if he did not go. Then B option, his mother said that he had done his best, so he should keep his promise. And C option is, he did not care about the emperor's test. So the correct answer is B, that his mother said that he had done his best, so he should keep his promise. Then third is, here are some words that tell us about Chun's character. Take the correct one. Now, what are the words which suit Chun's character? Okay, now see the first one, honest. He was honest? Yes. Cowardly. He was cowardly. Cowardly means darpok. No. See, courageous? Yes, he was courageous. Obedient? Yes, he was obedient. Then clever? He was clever? Yeah, no, he was not clever. Simple? Yes, he was simple. Shy? He was shy. Because when king asked him, what is your name? So he was very shy to give the answer. So he was shy. Then cruel? He was cruel? No, he was not cruel. Truthful? He was truthful? Yes, he spoke truth always. And foolish? He was foolish? No, he was not foolish. So these are the options which suit his character. First is A, honest. C, courageous. D, obedient. F, simple. G, shy. And I, truthful. So these are the words which suit him. So you have to do this three questions in your fair copy. And see, what you have to do, you just write the question as well as write the correct answer. No need to write all the three options. You can write only the correct answer. Like first question, you can write, why did the king want someone from outside the family to succeed him? And then the correct answer, that his heirs were lazy. No need to write the rest of the two options. Okay, so I hope you understand this and complete this exercise in the copy. And if it is possible, try to learn that and write in the neat handwriting. Okay, then next video, I'll be giving you the question answers of this chapter. Till then, complete your work. Take care. God bless you. Have a nice day.